tell me to be cautious. People tell me not to lose my self-control. People tell me to be flawless. People tell me not to let myself evolve. And I think I don't really get it. I think it's all just a peculiar game. And soon I'll wake up and I'll forget it. And everyone will know me by a different name. I want it to be stronger. I want it to be everything for you. If I could be stronger, would you believe that I could love you like you want me to?
Hey, good morning, boys. Seemed like on my last video there was interest in work capacity as a topic, and so I wanted to discuss like my current work capacity, how I built up to this, and you know, my future plans, and if there's time, maybe a little commentary on modernity and current fitness standards. So starting off, I do an upper-lower split 6 days a week. My upper is usually between 2 and 2.5 hours. I don't rest. I go in, everything is superset. If I feel like I need a breather, I will either, you know, pick up a 45-pound plate and walk around. I will do lying leg raises, which is an easy way to recover. You know, I'll do wrist curls. I'll find something to do where I'm able to recover cardiovascularly, but still be occupied, because I get bored, in all honesty. Like, I can't sit there and look at my phone or do anything else. So that's kind of how my upper works. My lower is pretty similar. I also don't rest. Laying leg raises, neck raises, calf raises, or neck curls, stuff like that, just to keep myself busy. But my lower is usually much shorter. Tends to be about 1 hour to 1.5 hours. And then included in both upper and lower, I do back every single day. Once I'm done with my upper or my lower program, that's when I set up the tripod and I film the monkey bars. And so that's it for all of my gym activity, you know, on a daily basis. Then I walk about 6 miles per day, you know, minimum 20K steps. And I've started swimming about 1 to 1.5 hours per day. And so when you put that all on paper, you know, it's not that much. There are people who actually work for a living and, you know, have to carry things and dig holes and pick stuff up and put it down and walk around and drag stuff all day long. And when you put my exercise on paper, it's, you know, it's only a couple hours. There's 16 waking hours in a day. And, you know, you can move your body and hoist things and row for 16 hours pretty much. I mean, you might have to take some breaks, but all right, now I'd like to get into more the history of how I got here. So 18 months ago, I was full emaciated COVID mode. I was just a skinny fat sack of bones. I did no exercise, no, not even walking. I barely walked. And so I started walking about 5K steps a day, then 10K, then 15K, then about 20. I got a dog, and so that slotted perfectly in. I just walked her on my normal walk schedule. And then I started lifting. I started doing strong lifts 5x5, and so the workouts would take me, you know, it was only 3 lifts. It's like squat, and then you do bench row, and then squat, overhead press, deadlift. And each session would take me about 1.5 to 2 hours just for those 3 exercises, because, you know, it's 5x5. It's long rests, and it's forcing progressive overload, so it's really fatiguing. I don't recommend it. The program's really bad. If I had to critique it and review it and change it, I could to make it legit, but it's bad. And so once I was able to cut the 5x5 with the three exercises down to about an hour, hour and a half, that's when I started adding more stuff. And so in the program, it adds, you know, some accessories to the end. And so the workouts went back up to 2 hours. And then I wasn't able to really increase the density from there. So I started going 2 a day, and I would split my squat session in the afternoon. So in the morning I would do, you know, the two exercises, in the afternoon I would do squats plus leg raises and hamstring curls. And so that was going 2 a day, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. And the total per day was maybe 3 hours. Now, I don't know about you guys, but Monday, Wednesday, Friday splits just don't cut it for me. I want to lift all the time. I want to lift every minute of every day. And you know, I know I can't. My body can only handle so much. But I definitely like to hit the gym once per day. And so I invented a new program. It's similar to the Natural Hypertrophy Guts program. It was like upper lower arms. I ran that for quite a while and slowly made modifications to the exercise selection, the volume, frequency, and intensity, and the split overall. And it evolved to where I am now. And I'm really happy with my training. Hey, I saved this part for last because I know only the real ones are going to stick around. I wanted to provide my own personal commentary about where we're at in modern society and the fitness standards. I think they recommend 10K steps per day and 45 minutes of exercise. And that's nothing. It's nothing. That's a starting point. And from there, you should be working up to, you know, 20K steps, 30K steps, and be exercising pretty much all day. Where we're at right now with working desk jobs and how everything is so fucking easy. We've invented tons of things which have reduced the requirement of work capacity. Like to get water even. Think about how they used to get water. You had to walk to the well. You had to draw the water up from the bottom of the well to the top of the well and pour it in your bucket and walk your bucket home. Now, I walk down like 2 stairs and turn a faucet. And all of these little things add up where you don't have to carry anything. You don't have to drag anything. You don't have to row a boat. You don't have to pedal a bicycle even. You don't have to walk. You don't have to do anything. I don't know if any of you have seen WALL-E, but we're actually approaching kind of like a convergence of WALL-E and Idiocracy. The two of those movies predicted our future bleakly, but I think accurately. And you know, it's a short-sightedness in technology and thinking where we're like, oh, we're solving all these problems, we're making everything easier and faster and cheaper and better, but we're not. We're destroying ourselves. We're destroying our humanity, we're destroying our minds, our bodies, and our spirits. And so that's what I think. I think that we are capable of so much, and modern society is shackling